Now, Bill, a judge has blasted the taxi industry for employing drivers with poor English.
Yes, Georgie, an Indian-born driver has ended up in court after a young woman was hurt trying to escape his cab, and it was all because they couldn't understand each other.
Ravanda Kang speaks hardly any English. He needs an interpreter in court, and when asked a question, says nothing.
You could get a job as a taxi driver without being able to speak English?
Sorry?
Yet he was qualified enough to drive a cab, a situation the judge found remarkable. After a night out at a Valley nightclub, three teenage girls caught Kang's cab. When they asked to be taken to Wynnum, the driver asked for the cash first. Neither party could understand a word that was said.
Are you going to improve your English skills?
No. My wife's job starts at 1 o'clock.
The judge lashed out at the industry standards. It seems to me highly understandable. Those who drive taxis have sufficient understanding of English. The community expects more. The failure to communicate led to Kang being charged when during a misunderstanding over fare evasion. One teenager fell out of the moving cab, leaving a large cut to her head.
At the start of his 15-hour shift, Kang was a victim of fare evasion. Four men jumped from his cab at Logan without paying the $40 fare.
The judge described Kang's behaviour as callous and offensive. The Cab Association says non-English speaking drivers is worse in Queensland than any other state.
It's incalculable now, but we do know. I think the experience you find every day is when you go to a cab, you can tell yourself.
Kang was ordered to serve 125 hours community service and no longer drives cabs. Anthony Donaghy, 10 News.